Steve Fossett's non-stop flight round the world hit a storm, plummeting his balloon into Great Barrier Reef waters. Military planes converged on his life raft. Also responding to the Mayday call was Laurie Piper, skipper of an Australian schooner, Atlanta.
Just tied around there. Jana, jump in the dinghy.
Laurie, his 16-year-old daughter Jana, and deckhand Peter Gill plucked Steve Fossett from the ocean.
Give me a hand.
Yep.
Safely back on land, he thanked his Aussie rescuers.
And then the Atlanta pulled up and basically woke me up. And sat down and had a nice dinner of mahi-mahi.
The rescue of the balloonist was just another chapter in the extraordinary life of Jana Piper and her adventures on the high seas.
If I had a chance to change the past, I wouldn't. I really feel happy about being able to say that I sailed around the world.
Hello, world.
Where are we going?
Around the world. I'm going around the world!
My name is Jana. I spent most of my life on a yacht called Atlanta with my father.
That side of it a little bit, don't
I? Oh my
God! Now I'm 16. About 2 years ago, I left the boat, and I've been back in Australia for those 2 years trying to settle into land life. I live on a farm with a lady I call my Nan. Now I'm just about to go back to the boat and I'm not sure if I'm going to stay or not.
Stand up.
But I sort of want Dad to come home, but I don't think he is.
Paradise, great place to be if you got someone to share it with. Been a hard sail getting here from Caribbean. All I want to really do is see my kids. Haven't seen them. I've seen Jana for 5 days in 2 years. That's not a lot of time for a girl going through puberty and my number one daughter.
Camilla, she's my sister, she's 14 years old. She lives with her mum in New South Wales and we have the same dad, but we have different mums.
No way, you stack me.
See you when we get back.
I think this trip that I'm going on now will kind of decide whether I'm going to complete the round-the-world trip with Dad and the yacht, or whether he's going to come back to Australia and join my life.
I'm still very tired. Well, we've got a lot of work to do today. Button both.
One.
about you, Bella. You don't hate me now, do you?
Pete's a great guy who's always been there for you. He was a deckhand. But close friend.
Here goes the chocolate cake.
It's good to see the gang back together again, like the gathering of the clan, as it were. They're the A-team.
Just watch out for the lines.
The first sail, I was a bit rusty, like, with putting the sails up and which way the halyards went. Like, got a couple of halyards caught up.
George, got your job.
But I never forgot anything, like, but I just wasn't in the physical practice of doing it.
Hey, Jana, you see that bit of baggy wrinkle hanging over the side? Just tuck it in for me, please.
I think it's important for Dad for me to come back on the boat because it's like the end of the trip around the world and it's really important to him.
Yeah, well, my intention to get Jana out on the boat now, we're so close to Australia, and I just want to finish the trip with her. Soon we started off together.
When we first left Australia for our round the world trip, I was about 9 years old, and we had Peter on board and my dog Cuddles.
Everybody, this is Cuddles, a little fox terrier cross.
What's her real name?
Cuddles. Cuddle Pie, and I'm Huggle Pod.
Wow.
Yep.
How you doing? Just fired the main engine up. This is a very beautiful moment now because we've been working a long way towards getting this outfit on the road.
Remind me to read this too. I've got a few more pages I've got to catch up on.
Peter'd have to be one of the best friends Dad's ever had, I think, and to me he's been like another I never had.
Stop.
I bought this little hi-8 camera and opened it up and got it going, and bang, I've gone through three cameras since.
That one records only if you hold it.
It's given me another reason for being on the boat.
Ever since I've remembered him, he's always had a camera in my face.
I've known Jana since she was, well, not long after she was born, I suppose. And to watch her grow up, it's been amazing. It's been a real honour to be able to focus, literally focus, through a lens of a camera and see this girl change before my eyes.
Hey,
Dave.
See you, mate.
Bye.
You happy with your chihuahua, mate?
A decade of getting ready.
A decade,
yeah. I love it out here.
Gonna wave goodbye to Australia, Narnie.
And I always had a dream of sailing over the horizon, seeing what's out there.
Well, we went to New Caledonia, Vanuatu, Solomon Islands, Papua New Guinea, Philippines, Hong Kong, Singapore, Thailand, Malaysia, Maldives, India, Sudan.
How you feeling?
Really sick or just a little bit sick?
I'm gonna spew up, I swear.
I thought that when I came back to the boat this time, my seasickness would be gone, but no, it stayed.
You know the best recipe for seasickness? Sitting under a tree.
Shut up.
Dad and Peter never ever get seasick, and it's not fair.
I guess I'm a sea person, there's no doubt about that. The only time that I really feel content within myself is when I'm travelling.
Roll a pinwheel!
And it didn't take me long to figure out that a yacht was the ultimate means of transport, where you've got your home, your belongings, your livelihood, and anything else I want.
He built this boat without any plans. He had them in his mind.
Building a boat by the thumb is the old traditional way of doing it. They used to build boats all the way through history by the eyeball and the thumb, and that's how Atlanta was built.
Atlanta, she's great. I just watched her grow from one piece of wood to what she is now, and yeah, she's great.
Even the ribs are laminated and glued. Should be pretty strong when it's finished. This is Camilla, and this is Jana, my two daughters. This is the good ship Atlanta.
Woo!
I'm a happy bloke, mate.
Hey!
Very happy man. See you in Tahiti.
Primarily, Jana and I are a unit. I brought Jana up since she was 5.5 months old.
My parents split up and I spent all of my life with my father.
It's always been Jana and Dad. We were a father and daughter and we travelled a lot of miles together.
My dream was to bring up my girl as a free spirit. And the only real way of doing it was, in my eye, was to sail around the world. I mean, you can't get much freer than that.
Right. Oh, we build a house out here.
Dad and Pete have always loved the sea gypsy lifestyle and the freedom of it. And I think they sort of like wanted me to follow in their footsteps.
This stays still, and the boat moves around it.
Well, I believe out here, there's a hell of a lot more to be learnt than the average school curriculum today.
Don't touch that, because I've got it set. Just put your hand on that handle.
Oh, God, we're doing 9 knots, Dad. Someone told me we're doing 9.
11°06.71.
Yeah, he taught me to navigate and how to use everything. But whether I was any good at it or not, it's a different story.
21 miles.
He taught me most of what I know, almost everything.
So 12 o'clock. Right, what's 3 sevens? What's 7 sevens?
49.
All right, what's 3 sevens?
What she's missed out on the yacht, she's certainly picked up in other fields.
5 sevens?
Yeah, in survival for a start. You know, she knows things that other people don't know.
That juice in that vertebrae is what will save your life if you're dying of thirst. Already I can feel it refreshing my mouth, and I'm not thirsty, I've just had a cup of tea, but there it is there.
Yep, well, you learn something new every day.
Fish like this, probably the best fish on the planet. I'll stop being a waffler.
Yeah, it's disgusting. I'm just doing a word comprehension on volcanoes.
Doing correspondence on the boat for me was really hard. I had a lot of trouble doing it.
Tower.
The hardest thing was just trying to concentrate when the boat's on a angle that you can't even stand up on. At port, I just found other things to do and distracted myself and couldn't do it. And in the end, I think all ended up overboard.
Jana.
Those 3.5 years were the most important years of my life. Learn, I think, from the world most of all. What my dad taught me since we've been out on the boat was probably a bit independence. Like, if I was just left on my own with nothing, I could survive.
Basically, if you're out there, no one's going to come and get you if you're in trouble. And you have to be prepared and capable of looking after that boat. It doesn't matter what breaks down, you've got to be able to fix it, because no one else is out there to do it for you.
He learned to ride while driving the plane.
Dad's more of an olden days person, where he's survived by his skills. He doesn't have much on a piece of paper, but he knows more than a lot of people I know, and he can do a lot more than a lot of people I know.
Small and weedy beast. Can you read the rest of it?
No, you read it.
No, I don't want to read the rest.
Well, on you start. But when he reached the big stone wall, down went the bridle hand, and loud we heard McPherson call, "Make room, or half the field will fall. Make room for Rio Grande."
Having a little rum punch at the end of the day. It's called 11sies, but we're doing it fives.
What you can do is you can set that foresail. You want to bring the hatchet in for the foresail, please. Go and get that.
When you're sailing, all you can hear is like just the waves lapping up on the bow. When the wind would go in the sails, you could hear the boom squeak on the mast, and you'd hear all the noise of the sails and everything. It was really, really relaxing.
There's just like one scene from every place we went to or everyone I met that I can remember, because there were so many things happening.
What'd you say?
Another one of those potatoes
that was in. Vanuatu, the best thing that I saw, I think, was the volcano that we walked up. It took us 25 kilometres to walk up and 25 kilometres to walk down.
Coconut number one.
That's good, all right, isn't it?
Mate, of all the drinks on this planet, this would have to be one of the best drinks you could ever possibly drink.
Cheers.
Dad brought a block of chocolate along to give us energy for the walk.
How are you feeling, Jonah? Bit of petrol.
The walk at site, we went through so many extremes of countryside. Yeah, it was really nice walk.
Yeah, sure.
You see?
Yeah, I see. Ah, oh, wow. The goal's in sight. Here we are, fellas. 10 minutes. Lunchtime.
Keep saying 10 minutes,
Sylvie. Yeah, we've been saying 10 minutes for the last hour.
That's island time,
man. Island time, man.
Island time.
How you going, Miss Mambo?
Good.
Beautiful thing, eh? You want a drink of water?
Yep. We're almost there, kiddo.
It's been a long, hard haul, I'll tell you. We got to be careful up here.
Be careful for the calf. If you fall in, no coming back.
Okay.
And be careful with the wind.
It blow you in?
Yeah.
Don't swear, Lori. Look at that mother! Jana, take a look over the edge! Go up to your daddy, I'll hang on to you.
I've never seen anything like it before. Oh, the energy coming out of it was incredible, eh? You knew that it could just cure you any second.
Okay, my friend. Hello, my friend. You are brave men.
Festival that they had in Malaysia with all these people, and there were these people that had big hooks in their backs with watermelons hanging off the hooks.
It was a tradition to them to put holes in their body, and I mean, people have lots of different traditions, but to put holes in your body and have people ripping hooks out of your back, I just couldn't believe that they'd have that as a tradition.
Jana, no, it's all right, mate. It's okay. They don't feel any pain.
I do. One of the fun things about living on a boat was like would have to be seeing like all the different marine life. Thank you. ever since she was little, Camilla always used to get up and sing.
If your life were any harder, would you still rush it around faster and faster? With your feet on the ground and your tail in the sea, your head in the clouds looking down on me, on me, on me, on me. We are your kids, we spin like tin lids, we go round and round and never stop. We are your kids, we spin like tin lids, and we know how to bop, and we know how to bop. Like tin lids, we go round and round and never stop. We are your kids. We spin like tin lids. We know how to bop. We know how to bop. We know how to bop. And we know how to bop.
Sexy sister.
I wanted Camilla to come out on this trip this time because I'd know she hadn't come out very often, and she was my sister and I hadn't seen her for ages.
On the beautiful yacht, Atlanta. Wow.
With the crabby father,
isn't
Laurie.
It's a beauty.
Just like that. And then you get these and you pull them up tight so they can come off. And you put them on this plate.
I already knew that.
It's been really good to know my sister, Jana, because I haven't spent much time with her in my life in general.
Can you let this sheet off a bit, please?
It's interesting because I always wondered what she'd be like.
Save me!
I love how she protects me and stands up for me, no matter what, you know. If any other kid's ever given me any kind of problems, you know, Jana will always jump in and say, hey, get lost. That's happened a few times, and I love that. And because she's just so gutsy and she just doesn't care, you know. That's what I love about her too, you know.
Don't hold that one.
This is only the second time I've ever been on board with Camilla overseas. We were in Thailand and she came out for about 6 months.
This ship was launched in 1982.
Woo!
This wonderful ship Atlanta was launched in Twofold Bay, New South Wales, and now on her 9th birthday, she's anchored at paradise.
She's virtually spent 9 years of her life at sea. All her life she's been going somewhere. All right.
Just sing all of it and then just go down to the
school. Oh, well, ever since we were really little, we used to just make up songs and sing them together.
Hi, I'm Camilla. This is the making of our new song called Box of Chocolates.
Life is like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're gonna get. When you look inside that box of chocolates, then you know what you're going to get.
Nigel's present, Jackson's present.
Who's Nigel and Jackson?
They're my stepbrothers. This is for my stepdaddy, Desmond. This is for Pop. And this is for Nan. I think she loved this. And here's Mummy's present.
What's in there?
I can't tell you.
Right from the start, I was always with Mum, and Dad was always with Jana. I think it's really good that they've got a really close relationship because Jana doesn't have much else, you know.
There's definitely a similarity between Jana and myself, whether it is because Jana didn't have a mother and I didn't have a mother, I don't know.
We never even really spoke about the subject, but I didn't exactly click that we both didn't have mums, really.
pretty bizarre. The major problem with my mother was that I don't think she was a very good mother, or I might have not been a good daughter, one of the two. I was the first child, and she left me with my dad. And it was a bit funny, like with her other two children, she left them with their dad as well. So when you think about it, it can't have been me if it happened to them as well.
Life is like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're gonna get. Look inside that box of chocolates. You might just find what you're gonna get.
What's going on, babe?
There'll be a world for you, a world for me, a world for us, both to see. That's why, oh why. Life is like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're gonna get. Look inside that box of chocolates. You might just find what you're gonna get. There'll be a world for you, a world for me, a world for us, both to see. That's why, oh why.
Looking after Dad and giving him so much attention was probably because, like, he didn't have a partner on board, and it was probably one of the more instinctive things I did.
For you, a world for me, a world for us, both to see. That's why, oh why. Life is like a box of chocolates.
I think I was about 9 or 10 years old when I had my first dive. It's just like, yes, I'm finally going to be able to be a big person and dive.
Where's that Jana? Cuddles? Take your gear off. One.
I love diving with Dad, it's really fun. Reminds me of when I was little, and yeah, it's a little tradition we have just to go for a dive whenever I come out. When I'm underwater, I just feel like I float all the time, and oh, it's great. It's like you feel like you can fly, because all you have to do is duck your head and you can go zooming down, breathe in, and you go up over a rock or something. It's like you're flying.
Dinner, the last supper.
What is this, Daddy?
Fish.
Yeah, but what sort of fish?
It's, I don't know.
When we'd go out on really long trips, rice and canned food were practically the only things that would keep well on board. We'd always catch lots of fish, so it'd be fish and rice. What's for dinner? Fish and rice. What's for tea? Fish and rice. Fish and rice. Fish and rice. Fish and rice.
Oi, crummy.
What?
Don't be so crummy with the crumbs.
I'll
eat one. Now, you tell me, what is it, fish or chicken?
I think it's chicken.
What came first, the chicken or the egg?
The shell.
Yeah. What's Beethoven's favourite food, Jana?
Banana.
Oh, God.
I was saying that everybody will eat 5 bananas a sitting. That is 15 bananas a day for everybody.
I'll give you bananas.
Chartering the boat was one of the ways that we made our money to go around the world. We could do like month charters, week charters, or just day charters. And people would just come and pay lots of money to sit on our boat.
6 teas and 3 coffees.
Other people might find it like spending lots of time with heaps of other people in their space annoying or discomforting, but I just felt it was just normal for me. For me, back then it just seemed the same to make and lose friends. Like, it was just, they just, like, they came and they just went again. Like, you could never get really, really close to anyone because, like, nothing really lasted for a long time. I definitely would have got lonely without Cuddles. I just would have got bored a lot quicker. She was my friend. She was just a friend. It was just like all I had. If I didn't have Cuddles there, I probably would have gone insane and done some stupid thing like jump off the boat in the middle of the night or something. But no, I couldn't leave Cuddles behind. And I felt really guilty because when I left the boat, that's when she died. Like, I felt that she didn't want to die in front of me. Very hard to come back this time without, like, it's like everywhere you look, it's where's Cuddles, and I hate it, I really do. If she was here, I'd probably go home on the boat with Dad and keep going, but no, there's nothing here for me anymore. Dad and I have got totally opposite desires. He's nothing without the sea, and I have trouble being without reality.
If I'm not close to the sea, then I'm not a very happy boy. I'd much prefer to be out in a lagoon, spearing a fish, eating fruit, and just being myself.
I got jealous of Atlanta because no matter what I said, the boat didn't have to say anything and he'd listen to her first.
I put years and years of my life into building her, you know, and we've sailed around the world together. And I don't know if you'd call it a love affair, but I mean, I'm definitely emotionally bound to her, you know. It's sort of not the same feeling as you have with toward the love of a woman or anything like that, but Atlanta's alive and she demands a hell of a lot more attention than most women.
It is the figure in my dad's life. There's nothing else really in my dad's life. just the boat.
But I'll never, ever get Dad off her. Ever. I really know Dad wants me to stay, but I can't. I really just don't feel happy at sea anymore. It's gone, I think. And I loved it. Like when we went around the world the first, like when you got to your destination, you'd turn around and you'd say, we conquered that, we did it. But I just don't feel that way anymore.
Oceans are rough. Oceans are wide, search for the secrets they're locked inside. Look one day and you will find that not all wounds are healed with time.
What's coming up there?
Looks like we've got a squall coming up. I don't know how much wind's going to come with it, but we're sure going to get rained on, I think.
We're going to get rained on, mate, that's for sure.
What is it?
Oh, that's right. I'll hand it down to you, mate.
If you've been away from the boat for a while, it seems that the boat's like really big and spacious, and the longer you stay on it, the smaller it gets, and feels like the actual boat's shrinking, and you're getting just slowly get more and more frustrated with it.
Okay. Hey, Jana.
No.
Oh, okay. Anyway, it's got to be done sooner or later.
Yeah, mate. Living on a boat was fun for a while, but then the novelty wore off and it turned into more of a chore than a life.
Bit of nor'easter in this. But I can assure you, no matter what way we point, it's going to be barreling right down on top of us, mate.
You wake up to it every morning and you think, I just wish I would give anything just to be at home now and just be able to walk outside and not smell salt air. But I think that's what Dad loves.
Sometimes when the weather's really bad and it's damp and miserable and the TV won't work, and when it's not one or two days, it's weeks that we've been huddled up down below, punching into heavy seas where you can't really relax, then it gets a bit tight on board.
You're down in business, Captain? Yeah, mate. Well, no one else was home right now.
Oh, Dad. You've got nothing else to do.
With all of us on the boat, there's a lot less space and a lot more people in the one space, and you just get tense easier.
These girls aren't so little anymore, are they, Laurie?
No, mate. They're growing up.
16. You were out of home by then, Dad. Think about it.
I've been 2 years on the road, mate.
That's right.
Yeah.
Oh, you'd have to rush, please.
All my clothes are getting wrecked. It's not fair. I hate this boat. Oh, bollocks. Who put bleach on this?
not I. Now all my clothes are stuffed. That's a good skirt too. My mum bought that for me. I miss my mum. I'm gonna go home.
Kids are a major disappointment. Gear all over the place, clothing and stuff smelly and that. I'm running around like a blue ass fly, keeping the show together. And when the chips are down, no one really gives a stuff about me or Pete. You know what I mean?
I'm packing. I'm going home. Ooh, hydrogen peroxide and ulcers. Youch, that's gonna hurt.
You shouldn't have hydrogen peroxide, don't you?
Bullet stings!
I've got my hickey, what's on my lantern? I miss my horses, I miss a warm shower, I miss a soft bed.
I miss my mum.
I miss school. This is all worth it, coming out here to see Dad when we're gonna get so far behind in school. And it's like he doesn't want us out here.
Yeah, now he's telling me, Camilla, you should never have come out here. I've got rashes all over my body. I've got ulcers from my feet to my head. It's not funny, I got them on my face. Let's have a good old whinge.
It makes you feel better, doesn't it? When we very first left Australia, I was deceived. I thought we were only leaving for a year. We just kept going and going and going, and after it had been a couple of years or so, I just thought, I want to go home now. That's enough. I've had enough time off school. As soon as we arrived in Greece, I didn't know I was going to be leaving there. I just knew I wanted to go, and that seemed like a pretty good place, so I left. But it just took a little bit of persuading of my dad, and finally he gave in and said I could go.
Where are we going?
Athens.
And what are we going to do in Athens?
Well, I'm going to fly out back to school for a year or so, back to Pinkham Bay. And you're going to get on one of these again and you're going to come back to Leos and collect the boat and go straight to the Caribbean.
Jana's been distressed and heartbroken at times and felt very much alone over the last 18 months since she got off the boat in Athens. But she is a gutsy little kid, man. She's done it so hard. I don't know if I've helped. With my nomadic lifestyle, somehow I've got a clear conscience.
Well, she's looking all right now that she's got it warmed up.
I think she starts working it, she'll be all right.
You hold this horse, I'll go get... By the time we went horse riding, okay. I think Dad had realised that I wasn't coming home on the boat with him. I really know he wanted me to come home. I just felt really bad because I think he was really relying on me to come home with him.
One more for good measure.
But I've got to go back to school. I can't just lose all what I've worked for.
Before we ride, we'll have to clean both her front feet out.
Okay.
Dad, no.
What?
Turn around.
Oh, pardon me. You did this one, didn't you?
No. Dad, have you got it all out?
Yeah, have a look.
No, you haven't.
Dad's getting old now, and that's really hard for me to handle, Dad getting old. I just don't want him to grow old on his own, and that's why I want him to come back to Australia, because I know he's never going to find a lady friend that's willing to sail around the world with him.
If I had to go home to a steady job, I don't think I'd live very long at all.
until I drop, I'll be sailing. I'll be going offshore.
One day I'll go back on the boat, but not for a long, long time. I think my life in Australia is more important now, but nothing be more important than Dad.
Look one day and you will find that not all wounds are healed with time.